Many developers say their least favorite part of application development is deployment. The process of building is thrilling until it's time to get your application out the door and working on someone else's machine. The industry took steps to address this issue by utilizing container technologies like Docker, but many solutions didn't fully leverage Docker's benefits and only ran containers in local development. Developers often push back on the complexity of running Docker in production, leading to the rise of platform as a service technologies. These platforms often relied on complex systems like Kubernetes, which conveniently connect to cloud provider APIs along with their expensive billing rates. Let me be clear, I'm not here to criticize Kubernetes. It's a powerful technology with its appropriate use cases, but many don't need the complexity that Kubernetes brings. This video demonstrates that it's easier than you think to achieve zero downtime deployments and 100% replication across Mac, Windows, and Linux. You'll see how we can run your application anywhere from a home lab all the way to a multi-node cluster with any cloud provider of your choice. We've released this new version of an open source tool called Spin. That's a lightweight tool that dramatically reduces the effort required to ship applications quickly. Spin focuses on simplicity, providing incredible features while giving you complete control over your server costs. Let's jump into a demo and let's see Spin in action. So today we're just gonna have a quick demo of Spin. I'll do a deeper dive in a future video, but we're going to install Laravel and get that deployed. I'll show you how easy this process is. To get you caught up to speed, just head on over to our docs. And all I did was I followed the instructions to install this on macOS, which is just a single copy command, paste it, and you're done. We also have instructions configured for Windows and Linux as well. And the only thing these machines need to have is just a running version of Docker Desktop or something comparable. So to create our new project, I'm just going to drop into my terminal and run spin new Laravel. And this process is using the server-side up PHP images to basically run a composer install of Laravel and all of its packages. Now, the only thing that you'll notice different in this is it's going to also create some infrastructure files. And the difference with that is we keep all of our infrastructure files within the Git repository so that it's easy for other users to just run a Git pull and get online. Now you'll notice I have a prompt here because since we are putting somewhat sensitive information in here, you can encrypt this. I'll cover this in a future video, but I'm just going to press no for now. And then we just need to enter in our Let's Encrypt email so that we can get a free SSL certificate. So I'm just going to do test at ssudemo.com. And now that I have that, I can open this up in VS Code. So we're going to do a code and Laravel. And you can see that the project structure looks almost the same. You can notice a few changes. We have some infrastructure configurations that are shared. And then we have our Docker file down here with some Docker Compose files. The cool thing is that Spin is just built on top of Docker. So the only thing I need to do is just run spin up. And then you can see that my service is online over here. And this will allow me to drop into my web browser and just simply visit localhost. Now, looking at this, you're probably thinking this is no different than Laravel Sail. That's a great observation, but here's the difference. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take this Dockerized application and we're going to push this into production. So to get our application into production, we can pick any host that we'd like, but I just went with Hetzner because you get a pretty decent server for less than $4 a month. But the only thing that we'll need to do is in this spin.yaml file is I've gone ahead already and I've configured this before where I set this to J for my user, and then I set my public SSH key. And I run a spin provision. It's a very simple command that will connect to this server and it will install Docker Swarm for me. And that will allow me to ship my application with zero downtime deployments, which is huge. So I've already gone ahead and done that. And then the only thing that I need to do is, since I have a blank Docker Swarm server, is I can drop into the inventory file, which is just a list of where my servers are broken into production versus staging. And I'm going to add demo-server.ssudemo.com. And all this is this is a DNS name pointing to this IP address. There's nothing fancy. This file is just used when we run our spin deploy command on what server we should connect to. Now, from a Laravel perspective, all I need to do is prepare an environment variable file. Now, since I'm using this one for my local development already, I'm just going to do a command C and a command V, and we're just going to rename this file to env.production. And this is going to tell us that this file is specifically for our production instance. So to change this, all we have to do is we're just going to change the app env to production. We're going to set app debug to false. And then we're going to change this over to https://myapp.ssudemo.com. And that's all you need to do to get this Laravel application ready. Now that I have everything prepared, it's just as easy to open up a terminal. We're going to do spin deploy. And what this is going to do is it's going to use my local Docker file, and it's going to build this Docker image. And it's going to take all of my Laravel application files and package it into this Docker image. It will create a registry on my machine because that's required for all container orchestration. And it creates an SSH tunnel to the server and pulls my application down, and it will execute my Docker container for me. Now you can see that the services are provisioning. It's starting to create things automatically. And once this deployment is finished, which only takes a few seconds, we can simply just go to our myapp.ssudemo.com and see exactly what I had on my development machine. Now let's take this to the next level. Let me show you how the zero downtime deployments work. So all I'm going to do is let's just switch over to our welcome.blade. And I'm going to change this. You can see it says doctype HTML. And I'm just going to change this to, let's echo out spin is awesome. And you can see for a system administrator, that's about the extent of the PHP that I know. But cool thing is from the system administrator side, we're going to run a deployment. Let's just grab my zero downtime deployment utility. And you can see that we're getting 200. And it's just echoing out what's the content on that page. Now, if I switch back to this, you can see this is continuing to provision over here. But if we switch back over and watch our changes happen in real time, we should see that our content will change and we will never see any sort of error that appears. And so now you can see that our new application is deployed and it had no downtime whatsoever. And to issue another update is if we do this of hello world and send that out, the only thing I need to do is just hit the up arrow and hit spin deploy, and it will repeat the process for you. Now, the really cool thing is that this entire spin tool is completely open source, and we offer this spin new Laravel template for free. But many of you may be asking about what about advanced things like Laravel Reverb or Laravel Horizon and integrating with things like Postgres or other database engines. We do have something that's coming out where you'll be able to run spin new Laravel Pro. And this follows the same exact setup of what we had before. But in this case, it's going to walk you through step by step and customize the infrastructure to what you're trying to achieve. So you can see that mainly this thing looks basically the same as the other install, but when I press no here, now I'm being asked, do I want Horizon? Do I want Reverb? Maybe I don't want Reverb. Maybe I want task scheduling. I could press enter. We can see that Redis is required for Horizon. I can choose, let's go with Postgres, and I can pull all this stuff down and it will just configure my project. And now I can start running these more advanced deployments just as easy as running spin deploy. I'll be sharing more on the Laravel Pro template in the near future, but if you like what you're seeing, you can help us out very easily by starring, liking, subscribing, or following us on X, YouTube, or GitHub. I hope you found this demo helpful, and I look forward to hearing your feedback on Spin 2.0. Thanks.